Hi friends, this is Mandeep. In this video, now we are going to see CSS selectors. How many types of selectors we have? Okay, the first one is basic selectors. And the second one is combinators. And the third one is pseudo elements. And the fourth one is pseudo class. These are the four types of selectors we have in CSS. And again, we have different types of selectors in basic selectors. Okay. The first one is type selector. And the second one is universal selector. And the third one is ID selector. And the fourth one is class selector. Next, fifth one is attribute selector. These are the five different types of selectors we have in the basic selectors. We will see the combinators, pseudo elements, pseudo classes later. Okay, first here, in this video, we are going to discuss about two types of selectors. The first one is type selector and the second one is universal selector. Okay, first we will discuss about these two things. Okay, now I am going to close this. What is type selector? Okay, first of all, here I am going to write a small one paragraph and some content. The first one is, here I have paragraph tag, and the second one is PR. Okay, here I have four elements in this web page. The first one is paragraph, PR tag and UL LID. These are the things I have in this web page. Now we are going to see the first type of selector, that is type selector. What is the name of this element P? To apply the styles to that paragraph tag, we are using P tag. It is very simple. Whenever you write like this, this is called, it is red color. Right click, open in browser. How we are applying the styles to that element? By using the, type of selectors here. Oh, okay. It's not applied by. CSS, oh sorry. Refresh. Here it is in red color. The color is red. Okay, we are applying these styles by using the name of the element. This type of selector is called type selector. The actual syntax is selector nest property and value. This is the actual syntax of the CSS to apply the styles in CSS. Okay, here P is the type selector. That means when you are using the name of the element, that is called type selector, and this property and this is value. Okay, for example, to apply the styles for this PRE element, how to apply? By using the name of the element, color is something. Just refresh. Yes, it is changed to light black. A little bit blue, light blue. This is type selector. And the next one is universal selector. Star is called universal selector. For example, I want to apply the blue color for the all elements. Okay, here I want to apply the blue color for the all elements. Then what I will do? Just use the star. Star is going to indicate the all elements those are in the body. Okay, here I am writing color is blue. BLUE, blue. Now save it. Now I am going to delete P and PRE. Refresh. Now the whole web page is in blue color. Like that. Now star means all. Now I want to apply the padding 10 pixels for all elements in the web page, which is in the web page. Then what I will do? Padding. Okay, I will give 50 pixels from top, left, right, bottom. Just refresh here. Okay, just I will give 10 only, then it is better. Now it is there. Now the li has 10 pixel of padding, this li has 10 pixel of padding, this pre has 10 pixel of padding, and this is all, this p tag also has 10 pixel of padding. These are the type of selectors. The first one is type selector, and the second one is universal selector. Here star is called universal, like global selector. To apply the styles for the all elements, we are using star instead of writing the name of all elements. For example, now I want to apply the, how many types of elements do we have? Here we have, the first one is paragraph, second one is PRE, and second one is LI. PRE and LI. That means we are writing the all elements here. This is called grouping. Okay. This is called grouping. Now I am giving font size. Now I am giving font size is 20 pixel. Now save it and then refresh our web page. The font size is increased. The font size of this thing is 20, this thing is 20, this thing is 20. Okay. Instead of writing these all elements which is in the web page, simply you can use star. What I will cut it and I will paste it here. Like that we can write. Still you will get the same output after refreshing your web page also. Okay, these are the two types of selector. The first one is type selector and the second one is universal selector. And in the next tutorial We will see about class selector and ID selector. Thank you, friends.